fire team will begin to unlock some of the mysteries of Oryx's inscrutable, loot-filled fortress. So let's meet the brave guardians who will be exploring and fighting. In the center chair, team captain, is our special community guest, Laced Up Lauren. Please welcome Lauren to the show. How are you, Lauren?
I am doing awesome.
So nice to have you here. Where can we find you on the internet?
You can find me here on Twitch at twitch.tv/laced_up_Lauren or at Twitter at LacedUpLauren, one whole word. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. It's our pleasure. How about a shout out to your clan?
Of course. The Cool Kids Table, I want to always thank them for, you know, giving me the opportunity to even come here and make a community that feels welcoming to every kind of people that want to stop in. So cool. Shout out to them.
Shout out to them, and we thank you for helping us to accomplish that goal. To Lauren's left, we have a man who is as wise as he is handsome. He's also my boss. Please welcome Irk.
It may or may not be a review period right now.
You ready to show him how it's done?
Let's do it.
You ready to show me how it's done?
Sure. I've got your account, so it
it was a last-minute substitution.
Grimoire score is pretty low.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Yeah. That's a test account. That is not my actual Grimoire score. And last, but certainly not least, to the right of your screen, we have Bungie Designer. Wow, that's awesome.
That's
2 minutes in.
Designer.
Bungie Designer Ben Womack. So, Ben, you are one of the architects of Court of Oryx. Tell us what we are in for today.
So, Court of Oryx is a new type of public event. It's player-triggered. You're going to play through the Taken King, explore the Dreadnought, do different activities, and get rune items that are going to bring back to the Dreadnought to a specific location, trigger public events anytime you want when you have the currency. And this is a desire to give players more public events when they want it, instead of having to travel around the world and not sure when they're going to happen. So I'm excited for it.
Public events and loot on demand.
Yes, exactly. You don't
want
no work, just the loot. That's what people want.
Free loot.
Of course, taking down these different bosses will be a certain amount of work if you know you consider battle and war and violence work, and you're going to be showing us how all of that works. We're putting a little bit more control into the hands of the player. They get to decide when these public events happen. They get to welcome other players into these public events, and it seems as if patrol is no longer going to be easy mode all of the time.
Yeah, you're going to get in there and you're going to realize that other people that are appearing in the world and helping you out, you're going to be glad that they're there, because some of this stuff is pretty hard. That's going to be really obvious pretty soon.
Well, let's jump into it. You are already on board the Dreadnought.
Yes, and, we're aboard the Dreadnought, but Lauren's inner menu here, checking out this new weapon.
I mean, I think this is what everyone has been asking about lately, is sword. Show me sword. So there you guys go. I'm showing the sword.
So this is one of many swords in the game. Obviously, this is an exotic version of the sword. It's a solar attack. And you can see from the fiction at the top here, these are earned. So you'll go on quests to get these. They don't drop in the world.
You can't buy them.
Can't buy them. You have to get your hands on them. You'll have to figure out how to do that. There are several different versions of those to play around with, so we're definitely going to play around with them today.
All right. Kick it off.
Well, welcome back to the Dreadnought, fellas. You saw this last time in the Twitch stream for the strike in the same area, but you didn't see a lot besides just running into the ship. Earlier, DeeJ said that we had a loot inscrutable loot-filled fortress, and that was because of the direction that Luke Smith gave us when we were creating. The big deal with going through the Dreadnought is you're not going to discover everything the first time through. You're going to have layers of mysteries and different activities and little events you're going to discover as you go. So, for example, off in the distance, there's a little taken object that we aren't really sure what it does. So let's go on over there and see what happens.
Let's poke it, see what happens.
Poke it. Oh.
Well,
these guys for you.
Disappeared. And actually, I led us into a firefight. Not exactly the best.
Got us into a firefight?
Yeah, something. You fight things in Destiny.
All right.
I've heard such tales.
All right,
you shoot things.
This, call it a taken ambush roughly, causes taken to start appearing in the area to attack your position when you just kind of are traveling around the world.
See, these are taken blights. They appear on the Dreadnought. They appear elsewhere in the world as well?
Yeah, the Taken can appear anywhere in any of the worlds of Destiny throughout their inscrutable space magic. And right now, they're just reacting to us being in the area.
They're going to react to my grenades. Yeah, you say inscrutable, and we've talked about the Dreadnought being this inscrutable place that you'll come back and visit. And I think for me, from my perspective playing, just kind of tooling around, what it means is there's just a ton of little clues and little strings that you pull on. And the more you tug at them, the more sort of adventures and loot and quests that you're able to go on, things that aren't necessarily given to you in the menu through the UI. They're sort of discovered out in the world.
That's right.
And so like, is that the core philosophy that you guys are going for, the Dreadnought? Like,
The core philosophy is people have reasons to come back to the Dreadnought after they go once. So for
example, you're not gonna be able to find everything the first go through.
Well, I hope not. Jeez. But we just got one of those things, one of those triggers for you to return to the Dreadnought. So let's take out these guys that are bothering us. Yes, protect us,
Irk,
protect us. Good job. You missed two guys right over there.
Got him.
Got him.
Great. Lauren, can you go in your inventory and look at that thing? This is one of our hooks. It's an item that you're going to get from killing those taken champions that you find around the majors we just saw. And it'll give you reasons to go through the Dreadnought and find more of them, kill them, and once it fills up, it'll have a new challenge that normally is not available and a big, fat chest full of loot waiting
at the
end.
That's what I'm talking about.
And that's kind of the modus operandi of all the stuff we have in the Dreadnought Patrol. You figure out this puzzle, this new, unique thing of an area or of a certain enemy you find, and then you're rewarded for it handily, and it just makes you want to keep on coming back.
It should be said there are other public events going on, like right now.
Right now,
it was in the menu, but we've got the enemy moving against each other, so the Cabal are going to take on the Hive.
Yeah,
it's going to get pretty nuts in here.
Fans of Skywatch will remember seeing the Hive fight the Fallen on the Earth, so and right now they're having a similar kind
of.
Do
you want to jump
right
in, or we want to hightail it?
I mean,
to
I see something over here in this corner that I kind of want to check out.
Oh yeah, so Lauren has a new ghost shell on that has a perk that points out specific destination material. And people, you know, find destination materials in the original game could be kind of a trial at times. So we're giving people ways to find them easier, more along the way.
It's a sad little thrall.
I know.
Anytime that Lauren sees this Warm Force new destination material in the world, there'll be a waypoint over it, there'll be a mark on her mini-map. And like, because I'm a hunter, I actually have a perk that shows them on my mini-map at all times. It's keen insight. That's why hunters are the best class.
Mm.
Yes,
mm.
They, no. Yes,
let's,
they are.
Let's not start with that.
All right, we already argued about that
Come
for
on.
Like an hour. Okay. All right, we're here for the Court of Oryx. We're going to take people, everyone watching, fire team, to the Hall of Souls, a new place we have not shown in Destiny yet, mm-hmm. and do some public events.
Awesome. The Hall of Souls. Every ginger will love this place.
You see the Hive love to decorate with cobwebs?
Every freckle is a soul.
That's what you keep telling me.
Yeah. I think we should make Ben an honorary ginger for our Court of Oryx time.
I have the freckles, man.
Do you have freckles?
Yeah, I signed up.
We can go dye his hair real quick. That'll work.
I don't think that counts.
Well, I guess, okay. Maybe if you do, it'll be okay.
So we're sort of in the guts of the Dreadnought now.
So
still some enemies to shoot, right?
Yeah. If you look out in the middle of this zone over the abyss is this giant gate. Giant arena. That is the Court of Oryx. But we're a little far away from it. We're gonna travel through some of these rooms alongside to eventually get there. Oh, knights, why you gotta be like that? Okay,
nice.
He's dead.
All right. It's hard not to shoot them.
Yeah. Alright. So we actually stumbled upon another little ambient event here. This is a Hive ritual that someone's taken. These acolytes were in some sort of prayer, and it's caused all of these taken to respond and appear in the world.
So we just came in at prayer time.
We did.
Perfect.
Good timing on our behalf. All right.
And sometimes we'll pass through this room and nothing will be there, and other times it'll be in the world, but in a different room nearby. That someone's one of these taken champion guys. He drops this little loot, like I got a little loot bottle. And sometimes you'll have a special enemy that will spawn that will have another secret, another mystery to solve. Now, we didn't get him this time, but we can get him another time.
There's always more.
There's always more, that's right. Always more in the Taken King. All right, so we're passing through here. Oh, another worm spore.
I need it.
Flipping on Lauren's screen. Oh, right, right to the right.
Oh,
I get to keep this, right?
Eric, why'd you gotta take it first?
You have to.
You have to claim it.
Oh, Wizard. Duty. I need a reward.
Help, Wizard. Thank you. Oof. So we're a little closer to the Court of Oryx now. You see all this green flowing stuff, electrical arcs on the surface. Don't step in that.
It's called miasma.
It's going to kill you.
It's a bad time. It's a bad
time. It's a bad time. I put it there because they don't want to guess.
I'm going to step in it now. I have to.
Just bathe in it.
All right.
So which way are we going?
We're going this way, past the giant pillars, past the hive crystals. Where are we?
Knights are just chilling.
Knights and acolytes.
This is like the hive. This must be like the hive break room or something. Boom.
Why you gotta be like that, knight?
Why you gotta be like that?
Why you gotta be like that?
All right. Oh.
Oh, there's another one there.
Blooming room.
I must get it.
All right.
All right. We've arrived at the Court of Oryx. Welcome. Lauren, not that way.
No, I can't. I was looking at
the
more.
Down
yeah,
see,
there was more. I'm like, sorry, I'm addicted already. I'm addicted.
Materials are so much fun now. So, welcome to the Court of Oryx. When we were designing this space, got some inspiration from Shadow of the Colossus. This cool fact of statues represent challenges that you're going to encounter it as you play through the game. Then you're going to come back and be like I killed that guy. Oh, I killed that guy. I got a great gun from that one. So, out here you can see that this is the arena where the event takes place. There's this giant portal on the back.
What happens if I go on the ground again?
Let's see. Let's watch what happens.
I think you burn.
No, stay down.
Stay down.
Back. Don't.
Back.
Oh. Well, that didn't work. So this is where the public event happens. And the way you activate public events is you take an item, a rune that you find in the world, and you go up to one of these statues, and you present it to the statue. Public event starts up. Everyone in the area can participate.
Sort of making a little sacrifice here.
Yeah. So how many people can participate in the court and helping out? It's as many people as in your fire team, and then...
Yeah, you can have 3 people in your fire team on patrol on the Dreadnought. The max people in the bubble is 9.
Right.
And so the impetus about this is that when you're doing these public events, you're going to see more people around the bubble that convene when it starts up.
Gotcha.
And because this is going to be a challenge level, that you're going to need them for.
And you can use other people's runes. So you can show up if you don't have a tier 2 rune, for example.
Right.
You could wait for somebody to drop one of those and jump into their thing.
The impetus is that people will respond to you starting up a rune, and they'll be like, oh, this is a perfect time for me to plug mine in.
Right, cool.
And then you can do back-to-back events.
And you'll see these in the world like a traditional public event. If we were out when we landed in for the first moment, we'll see that somebody has initiated Court of Oryx.
Oh, no, you have to be inside the area like any public event.
Cool.
So all right. Should I sacrifice?
You should present the
present.
Rune.
Present the rune.
And so what are we doing here, this first rune?
So this is the tier 1 of the Court of Oryx. This is the easiest one. When you finish the campaign, you get into patrol, you're going to be just about ready for this level of fight.
Oh god, it's called me.
We're going to crush it because we're way higher level.
Vorlog.
So the Court of Oryx bosses...
we got a dropship above.
All have a mechanic to them that mixes up the normal Destiny, sort of shoot aliens in the face kind of thing. Bullet sponge is not the method here. Figuring out how to fight the boss with their mechanic is the trick. And every single one has a different idea that you have to wrap your head around.
That ship hurts.
So this guy in the back right here, what does he have? He has this arc shield. Well, when we burst his arc shield, he's gonna come up with a different color once it regens. So we have to be prepared for that. We have to do as much damage as we can when the shield is down, because it's going to come up, and then my arc shotgun won't do as much damage.
So something like that. Just hit him a bunch.
Yeah,
with
just
the
hit
sword,
him a bunch.
You know? That's how I like to do it.
Yep. Okay, Lauren, I'm going to tell you to do anything.
It's a sword. I'm going to swing
with
it all the time.
Sort of easy mode with the sword, right?
Oh, so, loot.
The event's over. Loot has popped out of the chest for the summoner, Lauren, in this case. Everyone else who participates gets some chance at rewards, they get some rep, they get a chance of getting more runes for themselves.
You know what I get? Worm spore.
You get worm spore.
There you go. So the person who presents the rune, do they get more loot when it drops? And then the people who are helping kind of get...
It's their quarter, metaphorical quarter, that they're putting on the cabinet.
Yeah.
And they're going to get the big rewards, but the impetus, like I said, is that other players who are there will want to do the same thing. And they're going to help each other out. In fact, right now, Lauren has a summoner's exhaustion debuff. That's sort of just means she can't summon until it's gone. That's like 40 seconds.
Yeah. Right.
But then myself or Irk could have had a chance to put the rune in, even if we aren't in a fire team and communicating.
Just so I'm not hogging it the whole time, doing it over and over.
For everybody at home, gentle push to coordinate. They have no idea what those two things are.
Positive social experiences.
into a
dragon. You don't want anyone to like take your coin and say, like, yeah.
That's a currency that people used to use. Right. Metal money.
So we have a variety of bosses in Court of Oryx, and we make sure that you don't ever play the same one twice in a row for the lower tiers. So Lauren, if you want to go activate another one.
First one or second one?
Oh, the first one.
First one, okay.
Right there.
And so we're going to do these tier ones over and over again to get rewards, to get loot, to have fun with our friends, but we're also benefiting by
charging up our higher level runes that we already have in our inventory.
So you can find the higher level runes, but to kick them off, you've got to put a little bit of work into it,
yeah.
Spend some time,
because
they're
going to
lead us to better rewards, right?
You have to put in the
okay.
effort.
Okay, right. That is a lot of wizards. No, thank you.
All right, so there's three wizards here. They're right off the cuff. They just seem like they're kind of mages who have a little bit of extra health. So their trick is when you kill a wizard, if you don't kill the other ones very quickly, he'll respawn then.
So we want to whittle these guys down, all out of the ultras and crotomode hard, right?
That's right.
As if we were farming them for orbs.
We want to make sure that
we
get them down to pretty low health,
that's
and then we just leave them alone.
All right, so Alzok is going down.
Alzok's
so
almost
leave
ready.
Leave Alzok alone.
Guys.
Leave Alzok alone.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
I'm going to focus on Zyrok.
Okay.
Had a cousin
I'm
going to
focus
Zyrok.
On Zyrok.
Yep.
Oh, Zyrok's hiding.
He is wimping out of this fight right now.
Is he Zyrok doll?
Yeah, what's going on?
Uh-oh. Right. Oh, I missed that grenade.
Wizard.
All right, running. You got thralls on you. This is a pretty close quarters in here.
Yeah.
Can't really run and hide anywhere.
Staying on the move is important. Oh, I'm down. That's okay, though.
There's a
it's
wizard.
Okay.
You need a revive, or are you going to come up?
I'll come up, because part of this is getting people right back in the event as soon as they die. So you respawn pretty quickly, and really close by whenever you
all right,
fall
Gornok
down.
Is underneath the altar.
Okay.
I need some work done on health. Shields are going down now.
He's trying to protect his friend.
Shields are down. All right.
I'm punching things, as I must.
All right. We have about a minute and a half, so about half the time's done, so we're doing pretty good.
So it is on a timer. You have to complete it within a certain time.
That's right.
Gotcha.
Minute 20. So...
All right. Gormak
is
still about
ready
half.
When we want to burn him.
All right, let's kick Gormak down a little bit more.
Go.
I would say...
Ball then.
Go. I'm gonna... Trap him down.
Hammer time.
Beautiful. He's almost dead over here. There we go.
Boom.
Beautiful.
Coordination.
That was
beautiful.
All me. Good
job.
Coordination. That was all me. I got a fancy new
helmet. All right, let's go back to the hallway before the fire turns on. We all melt.
There's a chest down here, Ben. What's a key of gnashing teeth?
Oh, I would tell you, but many people would be angry at me if I revealed that secret. We don't want to spoil
By
stuff.
By many people,
do we?
You mean Luke Smith,
but,
right?
But the chest.
Well,
right. But the chest.
Many things Luke Smith doesn't want me to talk about. All right, so let's take just a moment to explain the whole charging thing. Lauren, if you go to your inventory, you'll notice that she has a stolen rune there that has two charges on it. And the idea is that finding this in the world, you need to go to the court, participate, help other players, do some lower level ones to be able to do the higher level one. And so we're going to do one more tier one to charge that up, and we're going to do the next level difficulty.
All right. Perfect.
Awesome. Are you still exhausted, or are you ready? Oh, you're ready. All right.
I think
yeah,
we're ready.
Exhaustion is just a little tap to say, hey, let someone else go if they want to.
Got to rest, you know.
Yeah.
Charge
take,
up again.
Take a breather. Change your perks.
All right, and so these bosses are rotating as well, right? So we're not going to see
the same one twice.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. So, like, here's two more that we haven't fought before.
Pronounce those names, please.
I've only pronounced them in my head.
All right, thralls. We got a knight up top.
A knight that's
and
really
a sword
angry.
Knight down below.
So we got two knight brothers
so
right here.
So we got
here.
A standard hive knight and a taken.
So you notice, shooting on them,
no
they have
damage.
Invulnerable
knight
shields.
Hurts.
We can't damage them. So the mechanic here is you want to lure the sword knight to his brother knight, and once they get close
Green
enough, their
knight,
shields
drop.
You're
luring him right now.
You're luring him up the stairs. That's the wrong, that's
very
not
interested.
Luring him in the right direction, you know? I'm gonna disappear, because that guy's attacking me.
Oh, all right.
All right, so I got super ready. When they get close, I'll pin him down.
Come back down.
Did I get close enough? Yes.
There,
all right,
him.
Get him.
Get him.
Open up.
Oh,
no.
Okay. Shields
all right,
I
all right.
just I pushed him
back
away.
Off for a little bit. That's fine.
Juggle him. Trying to push him off
Mangor
the edge.
Is full health.
You know, trying to push him off the edge.
Crowd dude.
Maybe?
You're not on your spear. You can't do that.
Ow.
All right.
Running and hiding.
All right. Run towards Crowd Dog. Oh, here he is. Oh, no. More.
I am down right under the start.
I gotcha.
All right.
Pleased to be helping.
Gotcha.
Right
gotcha.
Behind
gotcha.
You.
All right, just... Lauren, we're going to get them close together. Okay. You're going to uppercut that Taken Knight.
All right.
Ready? Go for it.
Oh, God.
Oh, no. A little farther.
No,
okay.
No.
Sword Knight. Hey.
Come here.
Hey, come over here. Okay, get him.
Nope. Lure him in.
Nope. So far away.
Come to me.
There
Invisible.
We go.
There you go.
Oh.
Oh.
Go back there.
Right,
go back.
I'm going to clean up some of the ads here if I can.
Okay, this guy's. Oh, nope. Got to choose your right moment. All right.
We got one.
Now, this guy's shield is gone because his friend isn't there anymore, so we can just kind of clean him up.
He is left alone.
Yeah. And use this other sword, don't we?
I'll just work on the ads here.
All right.
Nice. Storm
All
trance.
The way.
Boom.
All of it.
Perfect.
We are really good at this game.
That's the intention, for you to be good at this game, right?
Yeah. You're making me look good.
So we've completed our third tier two. Now we have the next circle charged up of Lauren's room.
Right.
So this is markedly more difficult. It's like kind of just below nightfall difficulty as far as power level goes. So we're going to have to kind of kick it up a notch. Herc, you have to start carrying your weight.
Get yourself together.
I just
let's
need
go.
My worm spore.
All right, so let's prep a little bit before we get that. Let's use a heavy ammo synth.
That's probably
heavy.
A good idea.
That's a good idea. Because we're going to have 4 minutes for this next one, but it's probably going to cut pretty close.
Right.
Normally, if there's more players, like if there was a fourth player, another fire team, like six plus,
then it'd be a lot easier.
We'd be kind of rolling through these. But, you know, when you have a lot of players helping out, that's what we want. We want players to be happy to see others appearing on the horizon to participate in public events. But just the three of us, we need to kind of, you know, put the effort in.
We're going to crush it.
We are.
All right. That's
go for it, Lauren. I'm ready.
All right.
I'm scared.
It's okay. We'll hold hands. We'll be fine.
So tier two takes bosses from the first tier, and you fight two of them at the same time. And there's a wide variety of them. So the impetus of these fights is determining which boss to take out first.
All right. Well, we've got an ogre.
Really
seems
angry
like a good
ogre.
Candidate.
So we got this ogre, and we got the two guys we fought before.
Oh, same guys. All right, so thrice for the ogre, run from the oh god, this is
This ogre will only have a shield break when an exploding thrall does damage to him. Right now.
All right. Can I hit him with a super?
Yep. Right.
Nope. Oh. And he was so close. So close.
I got him with a hammer.
Okay. Right. Got him down. Oh, gosh. I'm dead, too.
You're dead, too?
I'm dead, too.
We're good.
No, I must revive.
Lauren has events cancels in a timer. This is so that the summoner who gets the best rewards can't just sit around and AFK while people
just
do
wait,
for
yeah.
them.
Right.
They have to be in the fight, you know, alive to get credit and get the rewards.
So no AFK.
No AFK. We don't support that. We don't encourage it.
We do not support AFK. I am
no.
off the edge.
AFK is not supported. So this is the same boss that we fought earlier, but their power level is higher.
Gotcha. Well, we took out that ogre pretty fast.
We did. We did.
Very good.
Well, because we have these amazing swords. And also very good next year.
I'm going to go
use the hammer.
Swords?
Yes.
Swords.
See? Lauren gets it. Oh, I'm going to get you, but.
No.
Revive.
Nope.
All right. We got two minutes, 45 seconds. We can do this.
Yeah. We got swords again.
Yeah, we got swords. It's auto wins.
Wait,
swords.
I just got an upgrade for my pulse, so I got to get in the menu real quick.
That's okay. Just take your time, you know.
Just, you know, we only have 2 minutes.
All right, I'm going to start luring this guy. I have a super, so when they get close, I'm going to tie him down.
All right.
Let's get him a little bit closer. And
come on.
Here we go. Tie down. Open up.
Oh, my God. And, okay, they're far apart. Let's go.
And that's how you do it. Yes.
You got a calcifer. Nice.
More importantly, loot.
So, force loot rewards are much better for tier two. They're blue items, but looking at them in inventory, they're much higher attack and defense level than stuff you get from tier one. Sometimes you get really high level stuff that you can infuse onto the legendaries. So tier two usually gives you really good stuff. And tier two has a chance of dropping the third tier of rune, antiquated runes, which those are actually unique bosses as a different kind of a change of pace from the combos from before.
And I am the master now.
They're more like raid bosses than anything else. They have several mechanics, very specific strategies required to beat them, and their wards are really, really good. And just like with the tier 2 runes, you have to do 3 of the previous difficulty to charge it up all the way.
And tier 2 is the highest tier.
No, tier 3 is the highest tier.
Tier 3? Tier
antiquated
three.
Tier. Antiquated rune. Pay attention.
Oh, and how do we...
Do one more tier 2.
One more tier 2.
Do you want to do one more tier 2?
One more tier 2?
I think we could take a tier 3.
Do one more tier two?
One more tier two.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Did you just tell us we have to do a tier two?
He just wants to see more sword action. That's all he wants to see.
I don't think I can summon
DeeJ
it.
DeeJ likes his heavies.
Oh, yeah. Use the heavy sins if you have it.
I don't think I can summon it right now.
Oh, yeah. We have it's a minute cooldown. Yeah. Okay. We'll do it in the middle of it. Just imagine you're like fighting Crota or something. You forgot to get your rockets up.
But the boots still work.
Let's see. Oh.
I don't have the exhaust. I don't.
Oh, that's right. You already used your rune.
Yeah, I already used them.
Okay, I got one. Okay. Here we go.
You get more loot anyway, so.
Yes.
He's very generous. He didn't even think of that to start.
It's like, here, go ahead. You can take the loot. It's fine. I'm just like helping people.
So these are always combinations of the tier one.
That's right.
Okay.
But there's more combinations than there are actually tier one bosses, obviously. And we're just like tier one, we give you a different combo every time you summon.
Cool.
So it's a random order. They go through
so
the
So it's never
going to
be like, no you're going to do boss and yeah. the same boss again.
We have a drop ship.
This is
a
good. That's always the best.
Alright, so we got Brachus Horsk and Vorlog. So Vorlog's the guy we fought before. Brachus is this taken centurion who has an invulnerable shield. His shield only goes down once we kill all of his minions. But that's pretty tough with the ship going right now.
Just a little bit.
Why don't we go kill Vorlog first? So do you two want to follow me underneath right here? And we'll pull a master strategy.
Cheese spot.
This is what I do when I'm trying to beat this by myself.
All right. Okay. So stand next to me, you two. I'm gonna make this invisible. We're gonna jump top from here, the edge to the top, and we're just gonna mess up Vorlog. All right.
Oh, all right.
Here we go. Invisible time.
What have you done to me? I can't jump up top. I am Titan.
I am Titan.
Oh, the strategy was perfect, except for
Earth. Except I'm gonna like fall off the edge.
Oh no.
There's that.
The strategy was perfect, except it did not work.
Except so yeah, didn't every single part went wrong.
I've got a super up.
Yeah, so do I.
Okay, we're ready to try this again.
No.
No? You're gonna do your own strategy? Hey, I like my strategy. All right, I'm gonna pin him down. Oh, actually, I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna revive you.
Okay.
Then we're gonna do that. Okay, I got a bow ready.
Shields are down.
Ready? Okay. Pin him down.
My shields are back up. 2 minutes 20.
Perfect spot.
Punch. Punch.
All right.
He did.
One down, 2 minutes to go for the next one. We can do this.
Shadow Thrall.
All right.
That wizard's up.
So with this boss, we're going to need to make sure that there's one, before the last minion dies, we're ready to go down and do damage to him.
Okay.
So wizard's up, I'm down, right next to you, Lauren.
Gotcha.
So once you guys are ready, once you guys kill those two guys up there, I'll kill the last guy, and we'll just take on the boss.
Wizard's down.
Same moment. Cool. Okay, one more knight, here we go. Get on the boss. Get him.
Oh, Storm Trance.
had to.
Alright, shield's back up. Treat. Collect some worm spore, important part of the fight.
Get that worm spore.
Alright, so like before, we gotta watch for the last minion. And right before we kill him, we get ready to attack the boss. Kill that.
We got 118. It's not a safe place up here.
No, ship really hurts.
Okay, I think we have
this guy right here.
Oh, there's one underneath. Yep. Okay, here we go. Get ready.
Shield is down.
All right,
shield's back up.
Shield's back up.
Okay, one more phase. One more phase, and we got this.
Okay.
Just below.
And ship.
I got
that ship loves me, I swear.
The ship loves everyone. By design.
Oh, shields are down.
We got him without realizing it. Oh. All right. It's our last chance.
This is our last chance. Can we do it? You're back up. I think we got all this. Right. This feels comfortable. Kay. 16 seconds.
All right. Where's the boss?
Shield's still not down.
Shields are still up. There's a thrall right there.
Okay, here we go.
Punch him.
Shoot him. Yes.
Within seconds. Let's go.
Awesome job. Like my watch. I got a new sniper. Awesome.
I got the satisfaction of victory.
Yeah, let's go with that one. Let's go with that one.
You got some rough. You got some little things. And that's tier two.
That is tier two. Awesome. That's fun.
So we have a third tier, and we can start kicking this off. You guys are you
I
ready
think
for
we're
it?
Ready. We don't need six, right?
I'm sorry. No, I think we can. I'm really sorry.
Tier three.
I promised some very specific people on Bungie.net that I would, in fact, leave some things for them to discover on their own when
Who
they actually
are these
play.
People?
So I'm going to be the fun police right now. I'm going to step in and I'm going to say there will be no Tier 3 today. Tier 3 will just have to wait until September 15th when everyone else gets to play the Taken King. But we actually have some other things to reveal and to cover before the end of this show. So I will warn you again, do not kill your browser until it tells you that we are offline, because we have some things to share, we have some things to reveal, including some exclusive content for our live Twitch audience. So if you are in the future watching a YouTube recap of this, it's not the complete experience. I do apologize, but there is some virtue to having been there. The first thing that we need to cover is that, it's been a great year. We've had a lot of fun playing this game with you, discovering what you've done in this living social world. In a few short days, we're going to deploy Destiny Update 2.0. which will be the biggest change to the player experience that we've ever delivered, and poetically marking the second anniversary, or the first anniversary of the launch of Destiny. To take part in the celebration, our friends at Sony have sent us some of these. So you may have heard of the limited edition Destiny PS4. It's white, it's engraved, it's got art from the game. They've worked with us, some members of our team have put some effort, some tender loving care into creating this packaging and creating this device, and they sent us six of them. So we are going to send one of these home with Lauren as a thank you for being our special guest. And Lauren, we're going to invite you to give this away to a member of your community. So
Absolutely.
Someone who is sitting at the cool kids table is going to be the proud owner of a brand new limited edition Destiny PS4. Now, I'm getting a psychic message from some of the other hosts of our previous Twitch reveals. These have been a high point throughout this year, through the miracle of a webcam, looking you eye to eye, talking to you about some of the new things that are coming to Destiny, and introducing you to some of the different people who create this game, this experience that we all enjoy. So for the other hosts that we've had here in our studio to participate in those events, we're also going to send some of these out into the world. So that means Mr. Fruit, you're going to be able to give one of these out to the Fruit Nation. King Gathalion, you're going to be able to deliver one of these to one of your loyal subjects. Professor Broman, one of your students, is going to get a limited edition Destiny PS4. And of course, a member of the Rec Nation, courtesy of Triple Rec. So we're going to send five of these out into the world. I did say that we got six, but this one's mine. So this one's all mine. But we thank our friends at Sony for creating this with us and sending some for us to send out into the world. And if you are watching on YouTube, we do thank you for watching. Pause. And if you're live as a member of our Twitch audience, we're not done. So before we go, I would like to thank our brave fire team who has explored the Dreadnought for us. Laced up Lauren, thank you so much for being our guest.
Of course, thank you so much for having me. It was an honor to be here.
Irk, thank you for the lesson in how to play and talk at the same time. I've learned so much from you.
Trigger's on the right, DeeJ.
Yeah, yeah. And of course, Ben Walmack, this looks awesome. Thank you so much for being, you know, one of the people who created the Court of Oryx. Looking forward to exploring it ourselves.
Truly a pleasure, DeeJ.
So well done, all. I am your host, DeeJ from Bungie. It's been my pleasure to have you on these shows. And before we wrap things up, check this out.
We fought to keep our beautiful creation safe. And now this beast has come, claiming to be king. Marasov bows to no one.
Our guardian got a good look on Phobos. Whatever it was, it turned Cabal against Cabal.
They are taken. Oryx has arrived.
I will take them all.
Whatever you kill, Oryx will replace.
What's up, guys? I'm Luke, and this setup, if you could see in front of me, is totally crazy. There are like bright lights everywhere. I got Bungie behind me, and I just want to say a couple things before we let you go. One, I want to reiterate what DeeJ said. Thank you so much for the summer. We went from saying nothing about this game that we're putting out this fall to telling you a whole bunch about it. And in 2 weeks, you're going to get to experience it all for yourselves. We've saved an awful lot. There are a bunch of secrets left. And as you know, all summer, people ask us two questions quite a bit. They ask two questions about the raid. They ask us, what can you tell us about the raid, and when's it going to come out? We didn't answer those questions. We haven't told you anything about the raid. But today, just for you watching live, we're going to show you. Check it out.
Facing Oryx was never the end. Deep within the Dreadnought, his horde draws breath. You cannot face this alone. Six of you must rise and stand together as the king falls.